those comments. And
I want to know if you were right or wrong. That's a direct question. I expect a direct answer.
The first question is, given the open complaint and all the other concerns that I have addressed, why are we even here today?
Have you ever wondered who even needs Senate confirmation in the first place? Let's take an inside look into the confirmation process. We have to go back to the beginning. Have to go to the Constitution, 1789, Article 2, Section 2, Clause 2. And it says,
shall nominate, and by and with the advice and consent of the Senate, shall appoint ambassadors, other public ministers, and consuls, judges of the Supreme Court, and all other officers of the United States.
Donald Trump has announced a slew of top cabinet nominations, from his Treasury Secretary to his Attorney General. Over 1,000 people, including the heads of all federal agencies, are going to face Senate confirmation. Not everyone has to get confirmed. All cabinet-level officials and a lot of their deputies are going to need to be confirmed. But White House staff, think Kellyanne Conway or Steve Bannon, do not. The best way to think about Senate confirmation is through a series of steps. As soon as the nominee is announced, the media attention starts and outside interest groups get to roll up their sleeves. Step one, paper. The nominees have to fill out a ton of forms before they can get confirmed. Think of it like a job interview on paper. They have to fill out a White House questionnaire, pass an FBI background check, and fill out a financial disclosure form. They want to know every speech you gave, every club you're in. What's your 401k plan like? Did you ever have a DUI in college?
I don't know if I'm supposed to ask you this,
but Auburn
went.
I'm Harvard.
Step number two, the photo op. Here's where you get to make your debut as the nominee.
When I called you, you were all the way. I'm so glad you pulled over.
Step three, the hearings. Remember Clarence Thomas?
This is a circus.
The nominee is on the hot seat for hours. Once the hearing is over, those same senators are going to take a vote in committee. And if a nominee can get through committee, then they go to the floor for a full vote of all 100 senators.
I enter a motion to reconsider the vote by which cloture was not invoked on this nomination.
So how many votes do you need to get officially confirmed? 51 is all it takes. Supreme Court, though, is different. You still need 60. Given the Republicans have 52 seats in the Senate, you might think, Trump's nominees are a shoo-in. Senate confirmation hasn't always been that easy.
I take this obligation freely.
Dick Cheney was President George H.W. Bush's second pick for defense secretary. Bush's original pick was former Senator John Tower of Texas, but the Senate rejected his nomination in 1989.
No public figure in my memory has been subjected to such a far-reaching, thorough investigation.
You can pretty much guarantee that the Senate confirmation hearings on Trump's nominees are going to dominate the news cycle for a while. And maybe you won't stay awake the whole time, but at least now you know how they work.